ऑफ ए फोर्स इज नोन एज द नेट टर्निंग और बेंडिंग इफेक्ट प्रोड्यूस बाय ए फोर्स ऑन द बॉडी ऑन व्हिच इट एक्ट्स.
So basically, assume this is copy is a beam, so it is fixed at this end. So this type of beam is known as cantilever beam, which is fixed at one end. So suppose this type of joint you have seen in your door joint or window joint, where you can try, you can able to rotate the door or window by one end. So that type of joint is known as hinge joint, by which it is fixed. So in your body also you have seen, like in your knee joint or in your elbow joint, you are able to rotate your arm or your leg by this joint, na? You can see here. So that type of joint is known as hinge joint. It is known as hinge joint. Suppose it is connected to this end by the hinge joint. So if I'll apply some force like this, if I'll apply some force parallelly like this, parallelly to the body, then will I be able to rotate it or move it? So it will not move because it is fixed at this end. So it will not have translatory motion because it is fixed at this end. Otherwise it would have translatory motion like this. If it is not fixed, if I'll apply some force in this end, then it will have this type of motion. Or if I'll apply some force in the vertically along this direction, then it will have translatory motion along y direction. But it is fixed at this end. So if I'll apply some force along the line of action, whose line of action is towards this point, like this, along this point about which I am trying to do some changes with the object, then it will not move. But if I'll apply some force perpendicularly like this, then this end is fixed or joint connected by hinge joint, then it will try to rotate like this. Or if it is fixed or supported at both the end, if the beam is supported at both the end, then that type of beam is known as simply supported beam. Or if it is like fixed at both the end, then it is known as fixed beam. In that case, if I'll apply some force, if it is fixed or supported at both the end, if I'll apply some force, then it will try to bend the body like this. So the effect by which the body will try to bend or try to rotate by some force, then that type of moment is known as, or that type of effect is known as moment. So if it will try to bend, then that type of effect is known as bending moment. If it will try to rotate, then that type of effect is known as twisting or turning moment. So how we'll measure it? So basically it is the product of force and the perpendicular distance. The perpendicular distance about what? The perpendicular distance between the line of action of force and the point about which I am calculating the moment, that is the moment center. So this distance, suppose this force is trying to rotate the body, then the distance I'm calculating the moment about this point. So the distance between the line of action of force and this point is known as, that is the perpendicular distance or moment arm. So the moment is basically two types. It is either clockwise moment or anticlockwise moment. Suppose this force is, this knee represents its vector head or direction. Suppose this knee is acting like this. If it will apply some force, then it will try to rotate the body in like what direction? Like this, in clockwise direction. It will try to rotate like this. So this type of moment is known as clockwise moment. Suppose its knee is like this. It is applying some force. So it is trying to rotate by this, from this end by like anticlockwise direction. So if it will rotate the body in anticlockwise direction, then that type of moment is known as anticlockwise moment.
Next, we will talk about how we can represent the moment graphically. So force is a vector quantity, so it is represented by magnitude and direction. So suppose this is the force F, which is represented by this vector length AB. Its magnitude is represented by this vector length AB. So we have to find out the moment about this point O. So we have to find out the moment about this point. So we know that moment, the formula for moment is the product of force and perpendicular distance between the line of action of force and the moment center. So this is the line of action of force, so we have to decide the perpendicular distance or draw a perpendicular line to represent the perpendicular distance between the point about which we will find out the moment, that is O, and the line of action of this force. So we have drawn this. Now how we'll represent it? Suppose this point is C. So how we'll represent is moment equal to AB into CO, that is force F into CO. So moment is AB into CO, that is force F into CO. So if we'll join from point A to O and from point B to O, then it will look like a triangle. So what is the area of triangle? Area of triangle ACO is half into base into height. So half into AB into height is CO. So area of triangle is half into AB into CO. And what we find out the formula for moment, that is AB into CO. So if we'll multiply the area by 2, the twice area of ACO equal to what? Equal to 2 into half into AB into CO. So half and 2 got cancelled. So that is equal to AB into CO. So what is AB into CO? AB is into CO is the moment. So moment equal to twice into area of triangle whose base represents the line of action of the force and whose vertex represents the point about which we are finding out the moment or we are calculating the moment. So next is the sign convention of moment. So what is the sign of moment? So how we'll calculate the sign for a moment? So basically, I have already told you what is clockwise and what is anticlockwise moment. So basically, we take clockwise moment as positive and anticlockwise moment as negative. So basically, it's not a compulsion that you have to take clockwise moment as positive, but you can take anticlockwise moment positive and clockwise moment as negative. So if we'll take one as positive, the other one you have to take as negative, and vice versa. So now you have learned about the sign convention of moment. So I forgot to tell you what is the unit of moment. So I think you all know moment is the product of force and the perpendicular distance. So what is the unit of force? Newton. And what is the unit of distance? Meter. So in SI unit, at unit is Newton into meter. So next we'll discuss about a theorem that is known as Verignon's theorem. So what this theorem tells us? So Verignon's theorem tells us that the moment of resultant force about any point, so the moment of resultant force about any point is equal to the summation of moment produced by all the forces about that point. So what do you understand from this statement? Suppose there are so many forces acting on a body. Suppose this is F1, F2, F3, F4. They are acting on this body. So what will be the resultant force? this force is acting like this, F1 is acting like this, F2 is acting like this, F3 is acting like this, and F4 is acting like this. So what do you understand from this? So it is trying to bend the body or rotate the body downward direction. It is also trying to bend or rotate downward direction. It is trying to bend or rotate upward direction, and it is trying to bend or rotate downward direction. So what is the net force, resultant force? So if we'll take downward force as positive, then we have to take upward force as negative. So F1 plus F2 minus F3 plus F4. So that is the resultant force. Suppose we are calculating the moment about this point. Let this point O. So moment of each force about this point, summation of moment of each force about this point equal to the moment of resultant force about this point. So each force will produce, which will contribute some moment. So what is the moment of this force? Suppose this distance is A, here to here the distance is B, here to here C, and total length is D. So what is the moment contributing each force? So the moment about this point O, F1, into the perpendicular distance. But we have to check the sign. So it is trying to rotate. If it will rotate the body, then it will rotate like this, because acting in downward direction. So the moment it will produce like this. So it will rotate the body like this. So it is rotating clockwise direction. So it is clockwise moment. So we will take it as positive. Similarly, this is also rotating. It will try to push it or rotate it like this. So it will try to rotate like this, like this, like this. So it will also produce clockwise moment. So it is also positive. So F2 into B, and it is acting like this. So it will try to rotate the body like this. So it is rotating like this. So it is anti-clockwise moment. So it is negative. So minus F3 into C plus F4 into D equal to the moment of resultant force, F1 plus F2 minus F3 plus F4 into X. We don't know where the resultant force will act. So from here we can find out the distance where the resultant force will act. So we have to now prove the Varignon's theorem.